Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Apple just released version 11.3 of Big Sur. Let's take a look at what's new. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 900 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So while the new version of Big Sur includes a lot of different bug fixes and security updates, there are actually some interesting little features that you should be aware of. Let's start off by going to System Preferences. And under Siri, there are new voices. Here I've got it set to be American. And now I see there are 4 voice variations. There's Original Siri.
Hi, I'm Siri. Choose the voice you'd like me to use.
And there are also 3 others.
Hi, I'm Siri. Choose the voice you'd like me to use.
Hi, I'm Siri. Choose the voice you'd like me to use.
Hi, I'm Siri. Choose the voice you'd like me to use.
Now let's go to the Reminders app. And I'm really excited about the new things here. As you can see, enhanced sorting, print your lists. But that's not all. The sorting is here in Today. If I control click on it, right click, or 2-finger click on a trackpad, you see I can sort the Today list various different ways. But what's really exciting is I can go to a list like this, and now, finally, we can print. So you can print it out or, of course, save it as PDF or open it in Preview as a PDF. And yes, this does mean that once it saves as a PDF, you can now copy and paste the text from a Reminders list. Which got me thinking, maybe you can actually copy and paste like normal now. And it turns out you can. They fixed that. So I can select the first item here. Select maybe down to here. Now I can go to Edit, Copy. And then in another app like Text Edit, I can paste. And there we go. The text from the Reminders list can now be copied and pasted. That's going to make it much easier to export your lists for backup or other uses. Apple also added a bunch of new things to Safari. Most of it involves different APIs for developers of extensions. So you may see some more interesting extensions coming up in the future. Also, a few new types of web video are now supported. But in addition to that, you have one thing you can actually see and play with now, and that's here on the Start page. The controls for the Start page can now be organized. So for instance, if I wanted to drag the Privacy Report here to the bottom and the Reading List to the top, I can. There are a couple of new things in the Music app if you have Apple Music. One is now in Playlists, there's this little control here to make an infinite playlist out of a regular playlist. What basically happens is it'll go through your playlist, and when it gets to the end, it will continue to play songs to match the ones that are in that playlist. So it'll just keep going on. And also there's a new feature where you can see top 25 lists for different cities around the world. The Podcast app also has some enhancements, although I don't use it enough to really recognize what they are. Supposedly here in Top Charts, there are some more charts that you can view, and they go deeper perhaps. And also when you go to individual shows, there's some extra things, like perhaps I think these buttons might be a little bit different here. Not really sure what's new, but they list a bunch of new features to kind of make it easier to just download individual episodes and store them in your library. In Apple News, you can now more clearly see what's available in News Plus if you're a subscriber to that. And searching is now enhanced as well to help you find different things like topics, channels, and stories based on whatever it is you search for. Now, what a lot of people are going to focus on is the fact that there are new emoji available in both iOS version 14.5 and macOS version 11.3. So, for instance, we can search for and find face exhaling here. Another one is face clouds and also face spiral eyes. And you can see those 3. They could be used for anything that you want, although I think a lot of times they're going to be used in relation to cannabis. There are also 2 new hearts. There's a mending heart, this one, and also a heart on fire. There are also 3 new beard emojis. Before we had a beard emoji that looked something like this, and you could choose the style there, and now they've moved that. That's the regular emoji, but there are now 2 new ones. There are man and woman. And this one isn't new, but it's updated. If you do syringe, now you'll get one that has some fluid in it, not a red fluid. So I guess before they were thinking blood, but you know, the pandemic happened and a lot of people wanted to use this to represent vaccines. So now you have a syringe that's kind of more generic and can be used for that. You also have a bunch of variations of the kiss and couple with heart. So we can do kiss here and you could see these. There are now four of them combining both sexes, and you can pick the style for each side, one and then the other. So this is a new interface here. You could still use the generic original emoji for each of these. So you can do that with either the kisses or the couple with hearts like that. So what else is new? If you go to About This Mac now, there is a service tab here that gives you information about your AppleCare warranty. And you're supposed to be able to update to use the new annual AppleCare Plus plan. But I don't see that here yet. Maybe it's going to appear here at the webpage that clicking details will take it to. Now let's switch to my M1 MacBook Pro because I need the M1 processor to show you the specific things you need to do for using iOS and iPad apps on your Mac. There are new features that help you with window sizing. So now you could resize windows, and in full screen mode you can also choose to go with the highest resolution there. And in addition to that, there are options for gaming. You can use the Mac's keyboard as a gaming controller. So a lot of iOS apps allow you to use a gaming controller, and now you could simulate that using the Mac's keyboard. And even if you don't use a game controller for your iOS apps, you may actually tilt the iPhone or iPad to play some of the game. And now you can use keys on the keyboard for that. And in general on the Mac, there's more support now for controllers for regular Mac games. So new Xbox and PS5 controllers have been added as supported. And there are some other minor things and bug fixes as well. If you want to see the complete list of everything that is new, here is the URL to go to at Apple's site. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.